The following fight is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the white, red, and black trunks, weighing in at 136 pounds. He comes in with a pro record of 9 wins, 4 losses, with 5 big victories by submission. Hailing from Albuquerque, New Mexico, ladies and gentlemen, Jordan Espinoza. Out of the red corner, wearing the white trunks, weighing in at 136 and a quarter pounds. He stands in with a pro record of 8 wins, 6 losses, with 5 big victories by knockout. Hailing from East Providence, Rhode Island, the Portuguese man of war, Dennis
Guys, this is 3 rounds under the unified rules of mixed martial arts. I want a good, clean fight. Any questions, blue? Any questions, red? All right, back to your corners. Come out swinging.
Dennis Paiva, huge crowd supporters always behind Sweet Bread. Takes on Jordan Espinoza. 3 rounds of bantamweight. Nobody thinks it'll go that far.
Ready to fight? Come on.
This could be the best fight of the night.
Sweet Bread, known for his fast finishes. He's in southpaw here. Espinoza always high on the balls of his feet, very fast, very dangerous.
Coming out aggressive.
Oh, got airborne, he got counted. Here comes Sweet Bread! And Espinoza luckily got out of a dangerous predicament.
He leapt up into the air without setting it up and got clipped in midair.
Step across outside, thigh kick. Overhand right. Espinoza looks for a jumping round kick, almost got collected again. Gotta maybe stop the aerial tactics here.
He needs to go to fundamentals. I mean, the bread and butter stuff. Feints, fakes, good boxing skills, low kicks, front kicks.
A chance of Sweet Bread go up inside the Twin River Casino. Shoots in for a double. Espinoza drives Sweet Bread back against the cage.
Nice setup.
Paver won't go down, will he now? No, still maintains his vertical base. Gut munching knees there.
That was to the body, that was to the body.
And a glancing right hook from Espinoza, nicely done. Overhand right, Sweet Bread breaks free.
Paver's got to slow him down. He's got to either tie him up or use feints and fakes to mess with his head. Anytime somebody's using feints and fakes on me, I've got to do it better than them, confuse them.
Espinoza using a lot of the cage in his movement here. Sweet Bread catches the kicking leg. Espinoza says, you want to come down here? Sweet Bread says, nope. Step across outside, leg kick from Paiva.
Espinoza training in Albuquerque, New Mexico. That's above 7,000 feet sea level, above sea level. So he's got that altitude training. He can go. Just getting wild. I don't know what's up with him. Pretty amped up.
Nice two-punch combination. Espinoza shakes his head, disappointed in himself.
Piper really doing a good job staying composed here.
Maybe some frustration creeping in on Jordan Espinoza.
Piper needing to cut him off. Don't let him move anymore.
Counter right hand after the roundhouse kick. Espinoza fires the right down the corridor again.
I like Piper's style.
Sweet Bread again. Nice double forearm guard against the round kick. 2 minutes remains and a very entertaining opener. Body shot from Espinoza, but got a little sloppy.
Had a good job reacting, shutting down that takedown. Set that up a little bit more.
Espinoza takes a breather here. We'll have a look at the replay. And just a little flick there to the
curtain.
Feeling good? All right, yeah. Great
top time. Of the skirt.
All right, let's keep it clean.
Left hook.
Ivan needs to step inside those kicks. Start lowering the boom. Espinoza still on his bike. A lot of movement.
Left hand's working well for Espinoza now.
Yeah, he rolls off well at Mexican hook. When that lead hand of Paiva comes out. Roll with that poncho, step the angle, let that hook fly.
Drops him with the left hand. And he's going to invite Espinoza up. Some swelling under the right eye of Sweetbread, courtesy of that very fast lead hand of Espinoza.
Probably going to shut him down, get him against the cage. And let him move.
I have a hand right from Espinoza. Sweetbread smiles at him. Crowd inside the Twin Rivers Casino in Lincoln, Rhode Island. It's CS41 brought to you by Jimmy Birchfield, Pat Sullivan, and the team.
Check out some action here. There's the knees to the body here. That one was maybe top of the cup, but you can make the cup shift and give guys problems. Espinoza not stopping. And Espinoza landed a really nice right hand off that kick that Paiva was throwing. Got to be careful, got to be ready for stuff coming back at you when you're kicking, that's for sure. Espinoza, well, he pretty much dove out of the way of that punch.
Let's go, seconds out.
That's a good way not to get hit, but judges could look at that and go, that was a knockdown.
10-9 Paiva. Says Pat, let us know your thoughts on Twitter at Chevello Voice, at Pat Miletic, at R. Crump.
Round two, come on.
Paiva definitely had the momentum with him. Oh,
jeez. Oh, big head kick from Espinoza.
Gosh. Can't get caught with those. Especially when it's not set up.
Sweetbread on the back foot now. Aggressive start to this round from Jordan Espinoza. Muay Thai clinch and a jumping knee.
Paiva's back in it, it seems like. Able to react and stop that takedown. Got to keep your hands up. Lefty against a righty. The head kick, the rear leg head kick is always dangerous. Paiva's following him right now. He's not cutting him off. What Espinoza's doing on that head kick, he's changing levels like he's looking like he's going for a takedown and then throwing the leg high. Nice misdirection out of him. So Espinoza doesn't seem like he wants to just stand and box with Paiva. He doesn't like that at all. That's why Paiva's got to cut him off and get him against the cage and make him box. Can't let him out in either direction.
Yeah. little turning left hook there from Espinoza.
Yep, you step outside their lead foot, throw the hook, and pivot, and you're gone.
Continues to use all the cage. The more flat-footed Piva trying to hunt him down. Slick and evasive, Espinoza.
Piva got to step hard to his right, get his right foot outside of the lead foot of Espinoza, and keep it there.
Going to go into the third round for the first time tonight.
When it comes to cage strategy in a fight like this, the cage has to be your helper, your assistant, almost like another person helping you fight, blocking your fighter's movement.
Espinoza. It is all Piva doing the chasing though. Espinoza not really engaging. Can't keep him pinned against the wire. Oh. Nice right hand, backs up sweet bread.
Well, I'll tell you what, Espinoza's in shape because he's been moving this whole fight. Cut him off for a second there. Used the step to him.
We are going into the third round for the first time tonight.
See, with everything he has, and you're right here with us right now, you got nothing left, okay? You need to put pressure on this kid. You want to win this fight?
No, it looks bad.
Check this out, watch. Espinoza looks, gives that little dip like he's going to go for a takedown. And finally sneaks one of those head kicks in. Piva had been doing a great job defending against those previously. Up until that point, he recovered well. And there's that step with that left foot. And actually, Espinoza's foot was not outside the lead foot of Piva, which is actually very dangerous because when you turn then, you expose yourself angle-wise.
One round apiece, says Pat Miletic, as we move into the third and final.
Third and final, come on.
Little back fist tagged in.
Judges again can score that as a knockdown.
Nice. Trajectory on the round kick, goes for the body shot. Espinoza drifts off to his left.
Piva got to be careful rushing in. You know, you're kind of forced to chase to a certain extent, but got to control and cut him off. He keeps letting him skate out to his lead side.
Oh,
That was solid.
Espinoza smiling.
That was a nice
talk.
Yeah.
For the taking with 3:35 remaining.
Piper showing he wants to win this fight, that's for sure.
Nice. Can he corner him now? Espinoza turns his head of trouble.
Espinoza ducking like he's getting rocks thrown at his head. Which technically I guess they could be.
Yeah. Counter there, sweet bread. Almost halfway through this third and final round.
Looking for a choke here. Oh, he's sitting tight, dropping the hips.
Couldn't get it.
Espinoza. Nice hook. He's landed that a couple times this round.
And that right side of the face tells the story of that left hook. Piper blooded up here.
Espinoza winning, or Piper winning this round off aggression alone, to be honest with you. Espinoza looking at the clock on the big screen. Don't be a clock watcher.
Has walked him down the entire fight. A little turn off left hook of Espinoza. Still trying to land it. It's worked very well for him.
Much success. I'd like to see Piper make that jab and throw the cross with that left hand more.
Here Espinoza, Piper won't go to ground.
Beautiful job again. Piper's defended takedowns really well in this fight.
It's in the hands of the judges. Piper edging it out in the final round. Let us know your thoughts, your scores on Twitter at Chabelo Voice, at Pat Miletich, at R Kruk. I do have to agree with you, Pat. Piper just edging it out in that third, being the busier of the two, always on the front foot.
Yep. Espinoza just not wanting to get hit, period. Great athlete. Great skills.
Don't forget, for your fix of action movies, interviews, and more, check out warriorsandgangsters.com. Sign up now for your free trial. It's warriorsandgangsters.com.
That was a shin bone to the head also. A lot of people don't recover from that.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three tough rounds, we go to the scorecards. All three judges scored the fight 29-28 for your winner by unanimous decision. The Portuguese Man of War, Dennis Sweetman!